I mean, really, he's just given her a hand. Oh, no, it's become an evil plan. Yes, thanks, Anne. Over here.
He likes to get close to the birds, doesn't he?
It's just chicken.
Ah, that's a lot.
Chicken like you get from KFC.
I hope that dog bites him.
And with food served, the lunchtime assault begins.
Coming in, they're coming in. Oh, wow. Look at them swooping.
Get in there. Quick. Just get on it.
It's amazing to think that kites used to be really common throughout Britain.
In Shakespearean times, they survived by scavenging the streets and feeding off the carcasses of dead animals. Hence, they were welcomed as the dustbin men of their day.
It was actually illegal to kill a kite. In fact, in the Middle Ages, if you were caught killing a kite, you'd get the death penalty.
As our towns and cities got a bit cleaner, we didn't need the kite. They were exiled to the countryside. The farmers weren't too keen on them either, because they thought, wrongly, as it turned out, that they took newborn lambs and chickens. So eventually, disaster. The luck runs out in the latter part of the 16th century, when laws were passed throughout Britain encouraging people to kill kites under the guise that they were vermin. Well, this carried on pretty much uninterrupted for 400 years. And by the 1880s, virtually all the kites were gone, apart from about a dozen cowering in a little valley in Wales somewhere. Well, since then, various organisations have helped to bring the numbers back up slowly but surely. And now, perhaps that we know a bit more about them, we can coexist again, happily, with these magnificent birds.
That's it, baby. Work it, baby.
You get dizzy.
The kites have put on a spectacular display, so I'm hoping the teams have got some dramatic shots. Let's head back to camp, see what they've got.
Firstly, let's have a look at Alex and Carl.
Would you like him?
Oh, now that's a lovely picture. Look at that. That is a very good picture.
Yeah, we do. Yeah,
nicely in focus.
Thank you very much.
I like it. I love the colouring, the markings on it.
Yeah.
But you know, for
go
me...
Go on, but what?
No, I'm just...
What green?
But for me, the red kite is defined by its tail.
You can see the forked bit of the tail. Quite clearly.
Bill, we wanted something with action.
Action, and we
wanted the bird on the table.
So we've got four around the table.
Now, you know what?
Picking up.
I really like this one. I think this is brilliant. You see, what I like about this is that it shows, you see, the wings outstretched, the talons outstretched, coming in to grab the meat. It's a great action picture. So you win the photographic challenge. Yes!
And with that much-needed victory, Jeff and Joe are back in the game, trailing by just 1 point. Coming up, there's gold base mayhem in my campfire quiz.
Always believe in your soul, you're indestructible.
And 27,000 barnacle geese get the Joe Swash treatment.
What the heck you spook 'em for?
Welcome back to my birdwatching bonanza. For the past few days, our two teams of bird spotters have been competing to count, draw and photograph a whole host of birds. And as the night draws in and the campfire embers start to glow, let's get on with the next round.
And now we come to the campfire challenge. Alex and Cara, you're still in the lead, but you could claw back some vital self-respect with tonight's quiz. Alex and Cara, red, white and blue, their colours.
Is it a riddle?
In a flag, aren't they?
Yes.
But can you name three birds, one with red, one with white, one with blue, in their name?
Well, we have what we saw today, which was a red kite.
Very good.
There's the common garden blue tit.
Yes.
And the white swan.
It's not called a white swan, but it is a swan. You don't have to whisper either.
A white-tailed eagle or sea eagle.
Excellent work. OK, Jeff and Joe. Which male adult duck has no creamy yellow marking on its russet-coloured head? Is it the widgeon or the pochard?
Oh, wait there. We done this today, didn't we?
Do you see what I've done there?
What, say that again.
Do you see what I've done there?
I see you've done there. The widgeon had that little thing in the front, and you said that's why we didn't get the points. So the pochard.
Which duck has Pochard. No ream yellow.
Pochard
is the correct answer.
Yeah.
One more question. Very simple question. Can you name me Britain's smallest bird?
Wren!
I haven't heard the right answer yet.
Wren!
Robin. Meadow pippet.
A little
Britain's
sparrow.
Smallest bird, not a wren.
Sparrow.
Bee chomper.
yeah, yes, right. Yeah, the bee chomper.
Robin.
No.
Robin.
Smallest.
Storm petrel.
OK, I'll give you a clue. It's one of the elements, a precious metal.
Silver.
Gold. A golden eagle.
Gold.
No.
A gold. Golden hammer.
Gold.
Goldfinch.
Sparrow. Gold.
Gold
pigeon.
Gold.
Golden. Gold.
Oh, always believe in your soul. You're indestructible. Always believe in. That's not going to help.
Gold.
Something else that you might find on a bird. That's the second part
gold.
Of the
gold
name.
Gold feather.
Gold wing.
Gold bill.
Gold beak.
Gold wing. Gold legs. Gold legs. What the hell was that? Gold legs. Yeah, that's a gold legs. I'm sure it is. Look at his great big golden legs.
So after all that gold-based madness, Jeff and Joe are the winners, making the score 3 points each.
It's neck and neck as we go into the final challenge. Well done.
It's the third day of my Scottish Bird Fest, and this final round, along with deciding the winners of the competition, will also feature the Norwegian visitors who have been keeping us awake for the last two nights.
Hello!
Hey. Early. How are the previous. Other elves?
Oh, they're all back there. You stay back!
You little LP.
Oh, you wanted back at a garden centre.
Can I just
somewhere?
Say this, right? Hi, hi. Alle sammen. A bit of Norwegian for you.
You insulted my mother.
Yeah. Now, here's a riddle for you. I've got a white face. I've flown 2,000 miles to be here. I like it here. I'm going to spend the winter here. What am I?
Polar bear.
No.
Snow goose.
No.
Barnacle goose.
Yes, very well done.
Went from polar bear to barnacle goose.
There it is. Can you see? Now, this is the bird which is surrounding us, really, in this reserve, thousands of them.
Are they the ones that are making the noise?
That's right. 27,000 of these geese fly here from Svalbard in Norway, hence the Norwegian.
Did Jeff count them? Are there really 27,000?
No.
Or just 15,000?
Yeah, a dozen tops. And they're going to be spending the winter here in the Solway Firth. What I want you to do, I want you to get out there in the reserve, stealthily, quietly, creep up on the geese.
You hear that, Joe?
Yeah, stealthily.
Stealthily.
Quietly.
We've got that wrapped up.
Yeah. Okay. And I want you to read the rings on the geese's legs. There'll be a series of numbers and letters on the ring which will tell you how old the goose is. I want you to try and find me the oldest goose.
Why, are they like trees, Bill? The more rings they have, the older they are.
No, that's if you cut the tree with a saw. Oh, I don't want you to cut the legs open.
No.
That has not been approved by the RSPB. The oldest goose wins the challenge.
Well, do you want to bring you the oldest goose?
No, I just want you to use the scopes to get close to the goose, and most rings will get the best chance of finding the oldest bird.
So, do you get that joke? Don't bring me the goose, don't touch the goose. Now, not every barnacle goose is tagged, but the ones that are have a ring which contains a unique series of numbers and letters, but these are in code. So the teams won't know from looking at the rings how old the geese are, but I will.
What we've got to do, Joe, is find geese showing a bit of leg.
Bit of leg?
If they're not showing a bit of leg, we're finished.
Geese are in the field just behind these trees.
Joe, do me a favour. For once in your life, promise me, you know what I'm going to say, don't
you?
Be quiet.
Oh, of course I will.
You'll be in trouble if you don't, as these geese are easily spooked. They fly and graze in large packs with lookouts on the perimeter. If one takes off, they'll all go.
I don't think they're up to it, particularly with Joe. If he runs out into the field with a hammer, they'll have no chance.
I'll be staying in radio contact with the spotters all day to see how they're getting on. They just left.
Oh, that's such a beautiful goose. Barnacle goose is probably, in my opinion, the most beautiful goose in the country.
So while Alex is confessing his goose love, Jeff and Joe's patch is just too far away to spot a leg ring. I've got a horrible feeling Joe has got another cunning plan.
What I'd say let's try and scare them from where they are, and they might come over here.
But they, yeah,
so
but
I
they
clap
won't.
My hands.
Clap Wait. Your hands. Go on, clap your hands. Yeah, brilliant. Now.
Oh dear.
What'd you spook them for? What the heck did you spook them for?
He's got their attention, but he's moved them even further afield.
It's just too far away. It's time for plan B.
What is plan B?
Dress you as a goose.
Oh, now, watch him, Cara. You know how he feels about geese. That sounds wrong. Anyway, let's see how Dumb and Dumber are getting on.
What are you doing?
I'm going to see if I can get just a little
Look
bit...
at you!
I'm going to get a little bit closer.
Full of ideas.
This might be the world's worst decision.
I'm saying nothing. It's a good thing Alex and Cara are taking this challenge seriously.
I have one tag. Are you ready?
Yep. What colour's the tag?
Orange.
Yes.
Is the colour. And it's Delta. Delta. Yep. Zulu.
Hang on.
Well done, Alex. Meanwhile, the Chuckle Brothers are still building a bridge too far.
You beauty!
It's like watching Laurel and Hardy let loose in the countryside.
Do we have a rough idea of the lifespan of a goose?
20, 25 years?
So let's go 23 like then.
I don't think we get to make up the age. I think the tag's going to tell us the age.
I'm down.
Yeah.
I've got one. I've got one. I've got one. Get in the pen. Get in the pen.
Well done, Joe. All you've got to do now is write down the code.
You've got a pen. I thought you said you had the pen. Have you lost the pen? Got a pen.
Again, speechless.
B. One. B. One.
Yeah?
Wait, get some more. Man, it stinks. I think this is post manure. It's all over my hands. Jeff, got another one.
Yeah.
A. Four.
Yeah.
I stink. This is horse manure. You've put us in a load of horse manure.
Stay down. I can't. Stay down. Get some more. I've only got two.
That's it.
I think two's your lot, as Joe's had his usual effect again, and the birds are off.
Hey, Jeff, let's just get back, because I think we're going to be late. Come on, we're going to be late. We're
okay. All right, off you go then.
Right. Come on,
down.
Come on, Jeff. Come on. Let's go.
In the back of the net.
Back of the net.
Yeah, I'll be the judge of that. Shall we see who's Lord of the Rings? Alex and Cara got three rings. Jeff and Joe got two.
Two?
Two. Shall I tell you the age of the geese that you've spotted? You spotted a three-year-old male, ringed in 2006. 2007 was the other ring, so it was a two-year-old female, both from Norway. But the third ring you spotted was a male goose ringed in 1996.
Oh!
Making that a 13-year-old goose. That's pretty good. Jeff and Joe, you only got two, unfortunately.
But one of them had whiskers, and the other one had spectacles on and a Zimmer frame.
Well, one of them was from 2007, a two-year-old male. But the other one was a female, ringed 28th of July, 1986.
Yeah!
Making that a 23-year-old goose, making you the winners of this challenge. And ultimately, winners of this competition by 4 points to 3. So it gives me great pleasure to crown Jeff and Joe kings of the jungle. Sorry, wrong show. I mean, champions of my bird-watching bonanza.